Yes. Senator Marcos is recognized.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. I think everybody is here is wondering, why does SPMA or any of its people need an intelligence fund? We have intelligence agencies whose sole purpose and the sole reason for existence is to collect intelligence. Surely they can avail of that information if it is relevant to the conduct of the running of the SPMA. I'm very curious. And can you imagine SPMA, which is really a commercial enterprise in essence, has an intelligence fund, and now we learn that PDEA does not. So that would seem to be a very anachronistic kind of situation, and perhaps we could get a reasoning for that.
Mr. Chairman, please. Just an input that this appropriations for intelligence fund in agencies, including GOCCs, be on the approval of the Office of the President.
They have to, at some point, authorize the release of those funds. On what basis? Because when DPM sees a proposed expenditure that they do not approve, then they say we cannot release funds for that because it is not within the purview or within the project brief or whatever. So, what is the reasoning behind, again, the intelligence fund for these, what are essentially, as I said, commercial enterprises?
Your Honor, for SBMA, we do not release funds to SBMA. So it's charged their corporate funds.
So DPM does not at any point monitor the expenditure so long as the board of the SBMA approves these expenditures. Then the DPM does not have a hand in assessing those items.
Your Honor, if the corporation submit their corporate operating budget, then that's part of the expenditure which can be allowed in the approval process of the COB.
Okay, yes. So when they give you their budget, and one of the items in their budget is an intelligence fund, whatever amount it is, that is approved by the DPM and said that this is a proper expenditure.
Yes, Your Honor, but it is subject to the approval of the Office of the President. So it's part of the budget, but before they can expend it, they should get the proper approval from the...
Okay, when you get the budget from SPMA, and is the first office it comes to the DPM, and you look at it, and you pass it on to the Office of the President with recommendations as to approval or disapproval, or comments, or whatever other assessments you may be making of the budget that we're presenting to you?
Yes, Your Honor. When they seek OP approval for the use of their corporate funds for intelligence, then we would make recommendations to the Office of the President.
In these past years, you have recommended that this intelligence fund be approved by the OP?
For SBMA, I would have to check the records, but I'm assuming yes.
Okay, very well. And then, but the final approval comes from the Office of the President.
Yes, Your Honor.
Thank you. I'm talking on DPM and the COA. Would it be safe to assume that since these budgets that were proposed over these years were then subsequently approved and then spent, and then the Commission on Audit in their post-audit did not raise the issues, would it be safe then to assume that these intelligence funds and these discretionary funds, where uses for those funds were explained to the DPM and subsequently to COA to your satisfaction? That is why, as far as you are concerned, that these were proper expenditures for proper projects, as the Senate President has mentioned, in the intelligence area.
Your Honor, yes. Basically, what we... The GOCs, especially those who are income generating and do not get subsidies from the national government, under previous policies and other laws on GOCs, they're given that flexibility and independence in money or managing their business and then finances.
So these items on their budget are essentially black boxes. You cannot look inside them. So because they're intelligence fund, you no longer basta nakalagay dyan, ilimistas, intelligence fund, 5 million pesos, hindi niya sinusuot, hindi niya na hinahanap kung saan talaga napunta yung pera. And then the post-audit, the liquidation, you don't like look for receipts, look for a liquidation form, etc. Hindi na. Because by definition, it's discretionary. By definition, it's an intelligence fund. Would that be a fair description of how it happens?
Sinusuri naman po rin namin ho during the review of their COBs. Ang ginagawa ho namin, tinitingnan namin yung mga previous year's expenditures nila. Meron po rin tayong tracking.
So doon na namin yung pinagbabasihan doon sa trend ng... So maybe there's a 10-15% increase every year that's acceptable.
We also ask for some details kasi ho, lalo na sa intelligence fund. Even after it's approved in the COB, kailangan po pa rin ng recommendation for the president to approve.
Okay.
So we try to look into the details also.
So in looking into those details in these previous years, since as it is clear that the budgets were approved by the were not that no flags were raised by the COA in the post audit, that these funds, as far as the DPM are concerned and the COA are concerned, were used. You are satisfied that they were used for proper purposes.
Your Honor, ang sa DBM ho, ang ano ho namin, ang lookout po namin is the COB.
Yes.
So ngayon, compliance on how the corporate operating budget.
Okay, so yes, you are satisfied that they have complied.
Yes.
So
basically ho,
you must have been satisfied because you approved it. Oh. Yes, okay, so thank you. I just wanted to clear that up.
For SBMA, I need to look at the records on the approval of the COB.